Apple iCloud. Now, what does it do? How can you set it up? And how do you get the most out of it? Well, that's the questions I'm answering in this week's brand new series of Working with Apple. Hello and welcome to this very, very new series called Working with Apple. Now, this is just a follow-up. What I want to be able to do in this series is to take you through how to set up your own productivity system using Apple. Now, I'm only going to take you through the basics. I do have a comprehensive online course that you can take, details of which are in the show notes below. But really what I want to do is just to help people to get the most out of Apple's productivity tools, because they are actually quite impressive these days. Now, before I go take you into iCloud, and this is what this first episode is all about, I want to just say, if you do get any value from this video, and I'm sure you will, then please hit that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get all the latest news, tips and tricks on using Apple products for productivity, then subscribe to this channel. Okay, let me take you into iCloud and explain its wonders to you in this very first episode of Working with Apple. Okay, so if I'm going to start off and try to explain how iCloud works to you, I need to start with iCloud on the web, because this will give you the full overview of how iCloud is working. Now, in this episode, I'm going to keep this to its absolute very basic. So if you're looking for a more advanced tutorial, then this is not for you. This is just the absolute basic setup of iCloud, if this is the way that you want to go with storing all your digital assets, from photos to documents to your mail to your contacts to notes and even to your to-dos now, and of course your calendar. So if you're looking for something a little bit more advanced, then turn off now. That will come in a future episode. This is the absolute basic setup. So without further ado, let me explain. So if we look at this, this is iCloud.com. If you look at this up at the top up here, it's iCloud.com. That's all you have to do. You sign in with your settings. This is my demo account. So I have my email in here. I've got my contacts, calendar, photos, iCloud, Drive, notes, reminders, pages, numbers, Keynote. News publisher is because my blog is run through here. So that's probably not going to be there for you, and find my iPhone. And you can actually change your picture here by going into the account settings, which we don't need to do right now. Now, the key point to this is that everything that you store in the cloud on Apple's server is going to be here. This is like your base. This is where iCloud is basically kept. You can get access to everything from any internet connection except Microsoft Explorer. I don't know why. But your notes is going to be here. Your notes are going to be here. And your iCloud Drive is going to be here. Now, this is the one that I want to focus on today. Now, for all of those, if you really, really are new to iCloud, then I should point out that iCloud comes free with 5 GB. After that, it goes up. Now, the beauty for me I found of iCloud is that it is one of the cheapest ones around. Now, I can't remember offhand, but I will put a link in the show notes to this video for the latest prices on the Apple website so that you can get an idea. But I have family sharing, which I will explain in a future episode, which gives us 2 TB of space for just $9.99 a month. Now, I believe that Dropbox now gives you two terabytes of space, I should say. But I think it's now $12 or $14 a month. So Apple is one of the cheapest for actual iCloud space. So 2 TB is more than enough for most people. And I've got my photos and my wife's photos in there. And I keep a lot of my documents are also kept within iCloud. So this is how it's all set up. This is the way to see how iCloud is operating in the background. And any documents that you create, pages, numbers, and presentation files, if you're using that, you can store all that in the cloud, plus your apps and everything. So that's what I want to do now, is I want to go to my, over here to a folder. So I'm gonna create a new folder, and I'm gonna go to iCloud, which is here. Now, you're gonna see that I have got this partially organized. So First of all, we've got no tags. And this is something that I strongly recommend that you organize, how you organize it on your computer. So I've deliberately kept one out, which is like personal files. So I've got 2018 winter holiday. Actually, that's a bit out of date now. So what I'm going to do, and change that to 2009, which you can just do simply like that. And now I've got this one here, personal files. So if I tap on personal files and go up to this icon up here, which is the tag icon. Now, this is all my legacy labels that I've used in the past. The one I really want is personal. I'm going to tap that. And I've now got that set up. So that's how, and like here, I would never tag. These are just apps that I'm storing information in, and I don't usually tag those. You could, if you wish, you could create one called apps. But essentially what I've done is I would always have two tags, personal and work. And I would store my folders and files in there. Now I've got something here, adding, this is a, it's actually a video file. So let's just say that this was related to work. I would just drag it and drop it in there, and that would disappear. As you can see, even though it's a cloud-based storage, it disappears. Now this will show up on my iPad. It will show up on my iPhone in files. But it's just a wonderful way of organizing stuff. Now to set that up, if you go into this settings here, you have a lot of choices. So use groups, show group by, and you can, so this is the area that I'm looking at. Use groups, which I'm ticking, and group by, and I'm going down here to tags because this organizes everything by tag. And Apple has introduced tags years ago now, and I never really realized or never understood what I wanted to do with them. But now I realize that when you use it like this, it really helps you to organize all your documents between your work and personal. And you can go beyond that. In my real account, I actually have this set up so that I'm showing my two companies that I have, which is FES and CPP. And so as you can see down here, these are my legacy ones. This is my old computer that I'm using. And down here, these tags are all like done. Now, if you want to get involved in sort out your flags, you've got to, I can never remember this. You can go into, I should never have said this. You can go into Finder, Preferences, and Tags. There we go. And you can actually remove these. So I can go into here and I can remove some of these. So this is my legacy. So I can tap on that and delete. You've got the minus button down here. So I'm gonna command these. These are all my legacy ones. So let's remove these. I don't need to use these. And I have a lot, and I can just hit minus and they will delete the tags. Boom. And there's a lot. I have a lot of them. But let's just, so this is easy enough. I can just go in here and I can remove these. Like, it's a good one there is to have is receipt. But I'm just going to get rid of some of these because I don't need them in my demo account. And I can delete those tags. And hopefully they will go. So they're not gone yet, but they will go in time. So these are the two that I'm using. And I'm just going to highlight, make sure that's ticked. And if you want to do this one here, you can actually change the color by just moving to the side here. And you can go boom. And I'm going to, this is where I'm going to give that red. So I've changed the color of that, and that's red. So these ones, they still haven't gone. Let's see if I can get rid of them this way. And delete. Okay, so this one here, for example, I can now drag to here, and these can be used as favorites. But essentially, this is what you want to do with the tags, is just set up your tags. Now, there's another thing that I want to do before we finish this video is to show you that you can actually change the setting. When you change things like this, you can actually see this kind of setup. So you can actually see all your files in a list like this. You can see them as a grid. So if you've got a lot of them, then this grid works very well. If not, then you can set it up like this, or you can set it up like this. But either way, you can see that the tags are showing. So you've got all these up here, and you can even go into the old view like this, which I don't know why, because it's not very good. So you can change things, but what we're going to do is see things by tag, and that's the way to do it. So there you go. This is just a brief, quick, very basic overview of using iCloud as your cloud storage system. Over the coming weeks, I will go into a lot more detail and we'll get a little bit more advanced of what you can do with iCloud Drive, including like sharing documents
and so on and so forth. But for now, I just wanted to give you this quick overview and a really quick tip on organizing your files on your Mac, because this is a really good way of keeping things very, very easy to find. One more thing before we finish. When you open up a Finder window like this, you can actually drag your iCloud up to the top. So I can move that up here. So if you're using iCloud as your main drive, which I do now, I use iCloud as my drive, it's right up at the top there and it's set like that. And I love having it. I can just enter it so quickly. So there you go. Thank you very much for watching this first episode of my Working with Apple series. I hope you got some value out of it. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week.
Thank you for watching this video. Now, if you have enjoyed these Apple videos that I'm doing and you want to build your very own Apple productivity system, then please check out my Create Your Own Apple Productivity System course, which is available from my Learning Center and is incredible value. And it will show you how to bring all these parts together, the Notes app, iCloud, Reminders, and Calendar into one beautiful productivity system. Check out the course here. The details are below, and I hope to see you in the course.